What is up, players? It's Warboss Tay up in this mug. Welcome to my Glade Rider tutorial. This is for the Wood Elf Glade Rider plastic figure. And at the end of this tutorial, or the end of this video, this is probably going to be a two-parter, and at the end of part one, we're going to be getting all the way up to here. So the paints you're going to need are Celestra Gray, Rhinox Hide, Abaddon Black, Doombo Brown, Rackarth Flesh, Mournfang Brown, Kislev Flesh, Steel Legion Drab, Castellan Green, Lead Belcher, Warpstone Glow, Moot Green, Elysian Green, Wah Flesh, Caliban Green, and this is where we're going to get to. We also have the shades to do so. For that, we're going to be using Seraphim Sepia, Raiklin Flesh Shade. Do I use any other ones? Yes. Agrax Earth Shade. And this is the point we get to. So I'm going to be using, just for the new subscribers and viewers that aren't sure what this is, I'm holding my miniature on. I'm going to get it out of the way right now. It is a cork handle, or it's a piece of cork you get from any arts and crafts store in America. I get mine at Michael's or Ben Franklin, and you just stick some poster tack, or I think it's called blue tack, on top of that, and it makes a great handle for your miniatures. I'm using Celestra Gray as the first color, but I'm actually painting over this undercoat primer of Mournfang Brown. It's a Games Workshop product. They put out these color primers so you don't have to start from black or white. You can go for a color that's more, I guess, overall a general tone of what you're going to be working off of. And so I decided to go with Mournfang Brown. That's because there's going to be a lot of browns on the model, a lot of different shades of brown, dark browns, lighter browns, and I thought this Mournfang Brown was a great first color to choose. You could also go with gray. My usual go-to fail-safe primer is a gray, flat gray color from, I think I've been using duplicate color, flat gray. And it looks a lot like the bare plastic, so a lot of people ask on my videos if I even bother using a primer, I just paint on the plastic. I always prime my models. Just recently I've been using colored primers, which I've found seem to work pretty well, comparably. And I do apologize, this is the last video that I ever filmed at my old place. And having since filmed this video, the lady boss and I have made a huge move to a new apartment. And it's a little bit of a smaller space, but it gives me a dedicated work area. And I think a little bit better lighting, and it's just better conditions to be living in. So this is actually, I'd filmed this a couple weeks back when I was still preparing for the move, and I'm kind of surprised to see how much of it I was able to finish up before we left. So you're going to be noticing that the camera sometimes goes out of focus, and that's because I tend to be a little bit of a knucklehead when it comes to leaving items in the frame. You can see the paint pots and the hobby knife I've got back there. Sometimes the camera wants to focus on that if my miniature is not clearly in the center of the frame. Sometimes it thinks that the object to focus on is one of those others. Now, my general thought when painting these was I wanted all of my Glade Riders to be on white horses. And that's because when you look at my Wood Elves that I'm painting for this commission, there are a lot of greens, a lot of browns. They all kind of, unless you actually pick a model up and look at it, and you can see, oh wow, this is a lot of different colors you're using, a lot of the models look the same. And the Glade Riders are, they're special cavalry models. I wanted them to stand out. So even though the riders are going to be painted in pretty much an identical color scheme to the other Glade Guard, I definitely wanted the horses to stand out and to make the models stand out. So a Celestial Gray is a wonderful paint. It goes on really smooth. If you water it down a little bit too much, then it will tend to spread and thin out and be a little bit more transparent than you would want. So you want to be careful when you're painting on your Celestial Gray. I think in between takes, what I did was I let the Celestial Gray dry, and then I just went back over it to make sure there's no obvious paint strokes. You don't want brush strokes on your finished model. It's a lot more intelligent, and I think it's a better instinct to see any spots on your model that have those paint strokes, those visible ugly paint strokes, and just go over it one more time. It really isn't going to take you that much longer to get that smooth, even coverage. And the results really set your they will set your model apart from the others. So what I'm doing is I'm taking my Caliban green and I'm going over the model, the parts that I want to be the darkest green. And it's starting with the dark green, but it's actually going to end up pretty bright with the moot green. So all of this first application of the base colors is really more for me to see with my eyes, get an approximation of where those different colors are going to fall. I'm not sure if you might have seen my other Glade Rider Wood Elf video, but the whole idea with these summer themed gray Wood Elves is that I'm using the different greens to show a variety. Like if you go to the forest and you look around, it's not all one color of green. If you happen to go in the middle of spring or summer, there's a bunch of different colors. And to kind of show that whole spectrum, I'm using a multi-toned green and multiple colors of brown to really make the colors pop and really make the model stand out. Even though it's just a bunch of green and browns, it's going to be really beautiful to look at. Rakarth Flesh is my next color that I'm going to be using here. And what I'm going to do with it is I'm going to paint the spear. My idea for the spear is that I want it to look like it's carved out of a very light wood, and maybe even be reminiscent of like bone from, say, like a giant forest creature that has passed away at some point and is now like the Wood Elves have salvaged it and used its rib cage to make these spears or its teeth or whatever. I think it's a little bit more romantic than to just say that all they do is run around and sing songs and use the trees and stuff. I like to think that these Wood Elves are a little bit more pragmatic about their warfare and their tools. Moving on to the Rhynoc's Hide. Going back to the Rakarth Flesh for just a second, that's another one of those really thick colors that you want to be careful doesn't get too doesn't go on too thick, and you want to make sure when you're using your colors, you thin them down enough that you can really tell what you're looking at. For the Rhynoc's Hide, what I'm doing is I'm painting the dark browns now. Having painted my darkest green, or a little bit of it anyways, what I'm trying to do is pick out the dark leather, and I'm just trying to create a variety of colors. So you can see there's a lot of the model that's still painted in that Mournfang brown, like the horse's hair, the hooves, the obviously the base, which is going to get painted over, but the majority of the Wood Elf's clothing underneath that cape. I did paint, you might see a little slash of that Caliban green are used as leggings on the Wood Elf, and I just think that that's really interesting. Rather than painting it flesh color, I kind of like the idea that they're Wood Elves in green tights. So when you're looking at a model, the basic way that I approach it is when it's primed, or when it's undercoated after I've got all of my reference pictures and I've taken a look at everything that I'm going to use as a kind of a guide to how I'm going to paint it. I'm going to break down the different colors of the model, and that will help me to say, like, okay, which parts of the model are going to be which colors, because if you're trying to black out the colors and you're just going willy-nilly, a really common mistake is that you're going to get a lot of the same colors painted on in the same areas when that's you know, not really what you want. You'll notice that I didn't paint any of the Wood Elves' clothing, except for those tights under the cape. I didn't paint any of it in green yet. And that's so that I'll be able to tell, once I painted more of these other colors, I'll be able to tell what parts I want in which green tone. So besides the boots, I'm also painting in brown all of the straps on the horse, as well as the horsey armor, which I'm not really sure what you would call that. Those like scraps of leather on the horse's head there, and that little scrap of cloth or material that's on the horse's front leg. You're gonna find some strange things when you're painting your Wood Elves, and if you're not really too sure right off the bat what you're gonna paint those, they could cause you a little bit of trouble, because you could be painting it and you could be thinking, like, well, what is this? Is it leather? Is it just a really hard leaf from one of the big trees? So always kind of get an idea of how you're gonna block out the colors, what you're gonna paint them as. I think at this point I took a look at a reference picture of a Wood Elf from the Glade Rider box, and I saw that, oh, the shoulder pads and the gauntlets they've got on their forearms, those are also in a very dark leather brown, so that's why I'm putting some Rhinox hide on it. Steel Legion Drab is a great color. You can use it for hair. For now, I'm going to be using it for the horse's tail and the horse's mane. You can use it as a base color for any of the brown cloth areas on your model, and it works really, really great. I think I'm also going to use it for the quiver. The cloth of the quiver on the back of the Glade Rider there. And I think, yes, I chose a model that has a lot of foliage on the cape, and that's just to give you all an idea of how I would paint that. So I do believe I'm going to be painting all of the vines on the cape in Steel Legion Drab as well. Is this, I believe I switched over to Waw Flesh. So you'll notice in that shot, you can see the cape in the foreground. It's very dark green. And the Waw Flesh is a little bit of a lighter green. So it makes a nice contrast when you put those two greens next to each other. That's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to find all the different ways of contrasting the green so that it looks interesting. For some reason, when I see a model that is painted almost completely in, you know, one or two colors, it looks a little lazy, and I don't want to come across as lazy. That's the last thing I want to do. So you can see that there was a little bit of a skip. I let the paint dry. I went back and worked over a little bit of the horse's skin tone with Celestial Gray, and it really helps when you let your colors dry a bit, because then you can really block out, have an idea of what you're going to be doing. So now I'm painting with, I believe this is Wah Flesh. I'm painting the wrap around the quiver. And I've got my reference model right there to kind of help me out. I'm also going to be using it to paint the, I guess you would call it like the bottom of the blouse. And a little bit of the blouse itself. Going back to the rhinox hide, I'm going to be painting the arrow shafts in this dark brown, and that is really going to help me contrast so that it'll draw the eye to the color, make it look really nice. I think eventually I'm also going to be painting the saddle, I believe, in dried bark. Dumbo brown. I don't think there's more than one area that I'm going to be painting in this Dumbo brown, and that is the tops of the arrows there, the feather shafts. Wait, if those are the shafts, the feather. Yeah, then what do you call like the arrow itself? I always thought those are what you would call the shafts. Okay, I've decided to go with Mournfang Brown for the little overhanging leaf looking pieces there. Mournfang Brown is also going to be the color that I use to clean up the, I don't know what you call it, the banding around the waist, like the cummerbund of the model right at the waist. All right, back to the Rackarth flesh now. Just kind of cleaning up that spear, making sure it looks okay. I'm also going to be using Rackarth flesh to paint the, I guess you would call it the housing of the amulets, the setting, the amulets themselves, that is not the stones. Doing it now is going to help instead of painting the center in black and then working around it. By doing this first, you can really get to all the angles of that amulet and not have to worry about making any mistakes at the center because you're eventually going to be cleaning it up with the Abaddon Black. Back to Steel Legion Drab, and this is, like I said, where we're taking a look at the vines. Another point I try to stress with new and experienced painters is to always maintain your brushes and to always try to have the best brush available that you can afford. The point for this is that your brush is going to be the thing you're going to be using the most as a painter. And if your bristles start to fray, or if you buy just like a $2 bag of 30 brushes at an arts and supply store, you're gonna start finding that the quality is really not that great and the bristles are gonna start popping out. It's gonna be really just not a pleasant experience to work with. What I'm using is a Rosemary and Company brush. It's served me so well over the past year, and Rosemary and Company is a terrific brand and they're very affordable. But I've also used Games Workshop brushes, I've used Army Painter brushes, And the point is, you want to make sure you can afford, whichever brush you use, it's going to fit your budget, but that you're happy with your brush. Because Lev Flesh now for all the exposed skin parts, and that's really only just like the fingers, the arms, and the face. I wanted to make it purposely easier and more interesting to look at, more easier to paint, that is, by having the elf flesh only appear on the hands, the exposed arms, and faces. A lot of wood elves have their hoods up, and depending on which head you use for your wood elf, you could have a wood elf that doesn't have a hood, in which case painting the face is going to be a lot easier. You're going to notice that I've decided for the purposes of this video not to do a close-up on the face, because with the spear raised up like this, it's not going to be easy to see the face. I can show you how I'm painting the fingers here. I can show you where I'm going to be painting, but not only is the face or the head covered by the hood, but his lower half of his face is actually obscured by some green leaves or foliage or some kind of mask that he's fashioned. I say it's a he. I'm not sure if I've used the torso of a male or a female, so it could be one or the other. So I'm using very simple broad strokes to get the paint onto the arms there. Now we're moving on to Warpstone Glow. This is going to be our first highlight in the very bright green cloth pieces. And excuse the focus of the camera, but I'm really just copying the brush strokes that I've done before with the Wa Flesh as the first color, painting over that with Warpstone Glow. Everything is going to be painted over again in Moot Green. So mainly I'm focusing on the lower body and the upper body because that's where the majority of that Wa Flesh was painted. If you're breaking down your model by the different kinds of paints you're using on them, on the green cloth, then I would say that the Wa Flesh is going to be about 50 to 60% of the cloth on your model. Look for those big open cloth areas. Now, Moot Green is going to be the color you paint over that Warpstone Glow. You're also going to be painting that Warpstone Glow and the Moot Green onto the leaves that wrap around the quiver. So we're looking for a really bright neon greenish yellow highlight, and that's going to make your model pop when you put it on the tabletop. The tricky thing about wood elves is you don't want them to be too drab, or else what's the point? You might as well just paint them in all different kinds of shades of brown and give it a wash of Agrax Earthshade with some dark greens. I want my wood elf here to be very bright and vibrant. I want him to look like the forest that supposedly he came from. The next highlight color we're looking at is Elysian Green. And this we're going to feather onto all of the Caliban green parts. So the rich dark green is going to get this highlight of almost like a drab yellowish green. And the contrast from that is going to look really nice when you compare it next to the very vibrant, almost radioactive neon green of that Moot Green. I'm contrasting that bright yellow green with this dull mustardy yellow green, and when it's all said and done, it's going to look really, really nice. This actually has more of a, I believe, more of a natural look. That neon Moot Green doesn't look very natural at all, but it does look great on the model. And it looks very vibrant, very colorful. This Elysium green feathered right over the Caliban green is gonna give your model a more realistic finish, and I think that is really fun. And it's fun to find the areas to highlight on the hood there. As you can see, I'm kind of sticking to the edges of the cloak. The shape of the cloak I want to emphasize. I'm leaving most of that Calvin green in the center. I'm not really highlighting too much of it in the middle there, but I'm just giving an outline. And then following the flow of the cape as well. Next, we're going to move on to Abaddon Black. Abaddon Black is going to be what we're going to paint onto our amulets. And the reason for this is because we don't want to go right to the purple. You still got a little bit of that undercoat and those first few colors that you've painted on. So we want to cover that completely with black. We want to start from a completely black surface. So when we're building up the colors of our gems, they're going to really layer on top of each other nicely. Now with these guys, you might not have the model with the cape that has the amulets on the back, but I try to find the areas on the model that could represent gems. Like on the spear here, I found these two orbs right near the blade, so I'm just going to paint them as my gem color, and I think that is going to look really good. So Castellan Green is the next color that I'm going to be using, and it's a really nice drab color that is going to be perfect for our leaves here. It looks very natural, it looks very very realistic and very believable as the color of actual foliage rather than just something that is worn. It looks very very much like the camouflage of a tree line and tree cover. So that's what we're going to use to paint onto these leaves. You might not have this particular cloak on your wood elf. If you choose to use the Castellan Green elsewhere on the model, then that's also an option. See, it looks really nice when you contrast it to the Elysium Green and the Caliban Green. So Leadbelcher is it's a little bit of a controversial color to pick for wood elf because wood elves technically don't use metal. I believe that's kind of in their lore, that they're very natural and metal is an iron. You dig it up out of the ground. It's not something that grows in nature. But for these spears, I didn't really know what else to put on the blades. And I also thought back to the Wood Elf Gladeguard, where some of them are holding swords. So the Wood Elves definitely clearly use swords. You know, the War Dancers, the old metal War Dancer figures have swords as well. So they do work with metals. I think it's just more believable that they don't have too much metal, iron on them, or silver, anyway. The Seraphim Sepia is a great color because it shades the Rakarth flesh really nicely. It gives a very beautiful aged bone effect. If you paint Tomb Kings or any kind of skeleton that would have been left out in the sun and gotten bleached by the sun and just looks really dry and old and to that effect, then Seraphim Sepia over Rakarth flesh is a terrific choice. If you're doing more of a vampire count, like a dark, dirty, and kind of gothic looking undead skeleton, then I would go with maybe a Known Oil or an Agrax Earthshade instead. Seraphim Sepia is going to give you a much different finish. Raiklin Flesh Shade now for all the skin tones. Raiklin Flesh Shade is a very red shade, and it's going to dull down that bright Kislev flesh really nicely. Speaking of Agrax Earthshade, we're going to use Agrax Earthshade to color the mane of the horse, or the tail rather. And after the tail, we are going to go to the mane that is sitting on the horse's neck. So I'm going to be wrapping up the video here. Thank you so much for watching, and we're going to let the shades dry. We're going to let all of our layered colors dry. We're going to come back in part two in a little while, but it's been a lot of fun. I finished this entire Wood Elf commission, and I'm really pleased with how it looks. Everything looks really cohesive, and it's been one of the more challenging but also enjoyable commissions for me to paint, because these guys have so many little finicky areas for detail. And when I was thinking about the concept of the forest and summertime and how to paint these wood elves, it was really an enjoyable challenge. And I really encourage all of you out there to think about the color schemes of your miniatures and how can you translate the concepts you have in your head onto the actual three-dimensional model. Hey, if you've got any questions, please feel free to leave a comment below. If you'd like to support my channel, I've got a link down in the description to my Patreon page, and as well as a link to the Google group and all of my Facebook and Twitter information as well. So thank you so much, everybody, for watching. Join me for part two, when we'll be taking a look at bumping up the highlights and finishing up the model, doing all of the purple amethyst gems and all of that good stuff. So thank you guys for watching. Hope you have a great day out there. Remember, there's no better time to be painting miniatures than right now. So get that brush moving and get painting. Latest playos!